We'll use the same process as before, start and work our way around, starting with Soviet. The Soviets, there's nothing happened up here, but looking at some of their bases, we see that they're expanding. That's great. And we have aviation support at 64, and required is only 64, and we have 194 aviation support. Some of the bases are quite overloaded right now, so I'm going to take this moment and I'm going to transfer out the air, switch the aircraft around, shuffle them a little bit, just so that we can use up the aviation support excess from the other bases. If air units trying to train with less than optimal air support or aviation support, I think they suffer more fatigue on the pilots and planes. So we're going to shuffle out, we're going to move some of these forward bombers back to these rear areas where they have plenty of air aviation support and no aircraft. I don't think anyone needs to see all those details. Turns out there wasn't that much excess capacity in the Soviet Union for aviation squads. Had to transfer them all the way back out to Soviet Union and Alma-Ater by rail. Let's take a look at China. Having only one air attack on Changsha during the turn, I consider that a very lucky turn. With the Chinese Corps in combat mode, it survived without loss. One thing to note, this Chinese squad, the combat was here, so you can see the little X, and we retreated to the northeast. He's been battered, he still has an assault strength of 6, but not much more. So we're going to run like a son of a gun to Nanyang, if at all possible. We'll set the future for Nanyang. Just to take a look so the viewers can have an idea of the marching speed, we have this unit marching across open field, and he's made 14 out of the 46, so he will cross into Changchao within 3 days, and that's crossing a river and an open field. These units on the move on a road, but in the heavy duty, heavy forest, managed to cover 15 down the road. These units up here in heavy brush only managed to make 12, while these units in heavy managed to travel 5, trying to cross the river in rough terrain. Just to give an idea of the rates of travel in this game. We have an exclamation mark here denoting something that we should take a look, just show that the supply situation is low. In heavy brush, this unit has moved 30 back. Looks like he's running back to Cheng Chuxian, and he'll be out of here in 2 days. So that's a pretty good rate of travel, and 15 here. Examining the aircraft in the north, this is Hami. And we have some slivers or aircraft. I think the AI normally tries to fly them back together if they're close enough, but we'll just do it manually. We check by the unit order of battle and see that the rest of the unit is in Urumqi, so we'll fly up to Urumqi. Unfortunately, the other units are still disabled, but by taking the stress over the extra units, it makes them repair more easily. Unfortunately, Urumqi is now overstocked, and with more aircraft, it's just going to get worse. But the Chinese base force will have a maximum of 12 or 30 aviation support. Now that we've turned on the replacements, it's just going to take a little time. We noted earlier, previously, that the big concern is we have to examine closely to make sure that the enemy hasn't advanced into one of our hexes, so that if they do, we will have to move out of the movement mode and into combat mode, ready for the fight. But we might actually be able to escape. This one's of note because we're trying to move into heavy brush. We've only made 7 out of 46 markers. And this one's trying to move into heavy brush as well and only made 6. This unit moving towards I Chang has moved 16 units. It's on a road hex moving to the east. These units were sitting here at rest, so we're going to rebuild them, recombine them, set them to move, and I'm going to move into this swamp hex. The reason why I'm moving into a swamp hex is that way we'll have I Chang all surrounded, hopefully able to cut off their any supplies. The units moving from this hex are going to try to occupy this field. We don't have to destroy the enemy, we just have to be in the same hex in order to interdict the flow of supply. From there, we can move in. Burma, the Chilka was attacked from the air. It's a somewhat large, how much tonnage? 3,700 ton vessel. Carries 3,900. So we may not be able to reinforce Rangoon at all, except with maybe these very, very small AKLs. Changed my mind. We evacuated the Port Blair garrison. Instead of, we're going to put it at Chittagong, but now I've decided I'm going to unload it at Akyab instead. If we cannot bring supplies into Rangoon, we cannot force them up. The defense line will have to be along here, and we may as well start building it. This has an engineer force. It's very small, but it's better than nothing, and it does have some aviation support. So we can run convoys in from Chittagong into Akyab. The first AKL is already on its test run. The second group in Calcutta, unfortunately, we ran out of supplies. We've already run it down to 3,000. I don't know how, but we did. So we're going to move the larger ships out of here. To load the smallest one, form a new transport, and we're going to send the AKL off already, the one already loaded. Let's hope that their smaller profile might allow them to get through. Every ton of cargo helps. Here's a look at the operational report. Wow, we're going to be distracted. The ACM barricade lays a defensive minefield at San Francisco. Well, really? This is another one of those things that I didn't want to happen, but somehow I was transferring ships around and it loaded mines and BAM! So all those mines are wasted because the enemy rarely comes into San Francisco. So, as I stated a couple of times already, no matter how well you think you've planned, forget it. Something always goes wrong. There's one right there. We see all these detection reports, and there's just too many of them. It's just a flood. It's just overload of information. I just ignore them because you can't tell what is or isn't anymore. Like these aircraft, sighting. It's just a flood of information that mostly is probably wrong. Who knows? But who has the time to read through each and every one of these? We have some transports. Okay, well, we'll watch that. Service mission aborts mission and returns to Manila. A surface combat task force. Some repairs. Oh, these four, they captured Macon. The fortifications expand to size 1. Size 1 fortifications are almost like the simple slit trenches, slit trenches, that's about all they are. Very basic, very similar, very worthless. But you have to build them in order to get to size 2. And size 3, you're getting some respectable entrenchments. But 1 and 2, they're easily reduced and destroyed. We note the other taking replacements in San Francisco. Here's the low garrison leads to a partisan attack at Mandalay and Srinagar. We'll take a look at those quickly. The assignments, no, no, no. Again, lots of stuff here. Reinforcements arrive, that's important to note. Cape Town, Balboa, Aden, Mulmian, Sorbaha. More reinforcements arrive, San Francisco. So those are the areas we will have to examine. Here is Mandalay. We see that there's a red marker here. Yes, we are under. We've taken a little bit of damage on the airfield runway, and that's good, because I think sometimes they can even damage the things like resources, and these cost 1,000 points to supply points to repair. So this is a very light loss. The other one's up Srinagar, already noted. Here we are, we're under, and the manpower, industry, nothing has been damaged here beyond, well, it's already been repaired. This transport group has returned to Karachi and is trying to unload the 46th Indian. Here it is. We'll take replacements and also set it for a strategic move. Faster to travel by train than by ship. Just a quick look at the Abadan, noticing that how slowly they've only loaded 12,600 in an entire day. That's due to the port size. So small port equals slow loading cycle. Aden has received a reinforcement. It's loaded up, or trying to load up. There's still more supplies to load. Largs Bay, we may as well add it to the task group to load. Socotra. Okay, the task group is coming to recover her. She's going into strategic move to pack and be ready to depart. Diego Garcia does the same. Pack, ready to depart. I hope this is not a mistake. They have a minor base here, even a 1. I hope that they will still be able to take them off as a regular transport and not require an amphibious group to do so. Cape Town has received reinforcements. Two transports will form up in transport. We're 1 day late or so. We'll dock, load supplies, and where shall we head? Transports are best for using troops, so we will order them to disembark. Oh, let's go all the way down. The nearest one is probably Melbourne. Get the supplies into the pipeline, into the railway system. Too late for Adu. Adu is going to have to come out as an amphibious group because this has traveled. We are approximately 6 hexes out of Colombo. So in the next turn, we'll 2, 4, we are 9 hexes away. So a day and a half, we can't wait for them to load. Reinforcement Wapiti have arrived at. Oops, not Wapiti. Lysander have arrived. We'll pack them with new pilots. And turn on the replacements. We have 2 aircraft here, so we don't need both of them flying. The Lysanders. Oh, this one's going to be removed within a year anyway. We'll move the Lysander down to Cochin for possible employment. Where is that? Oh, man. For possible employment on Colombo or further forward. The 44th and 45th Indian Brigades are also unloading. I ordered them into strategic mode, ready to march on a moment's notice. Also turned on the reinforcements. The Gurkha Brigade is also unloading. And I've also turned on the replacements and set it for strategic mode, ready to embark on the train. Uh-oh, here is our vaunted counterattack on Chumphon. We're heading right into an enemy hex. I think we're going to. Oh, we still cut off the enemy. If we're in the hex, we will still cut off the enemy flow of supply, I hope. We're already here, so we're going to examine at Singora. There's a sub-patrol. Both submarines, and this is the one that's been damaged in the last attack, so we're going to return her, not to Sohor Baha, but to Singapore instead. It's just faster, easier to repair. The air looks like even the presence of a few fighters has kept the enemy from bombing Alor Star and Georgetown again, so even a few fighters in the air is enough, but our bombers have been badly beaten up. At Singapore, the Prince of Wales has arrived. We'll immediately put her into dry dock. Unfortunately, this means that there's too many. We now have 50 or 3 ships of 60,000 tons. So that, with priority adjustments, that I'm going to take the Monarch. It only needs one more day in dry dock, but we'll move it into Pierside. Hopefully it will repair and get out in 2 days. Notice how the red has disappeared. The Prince of Wales is now in the shipyard. We can also order the smaller ships, like the destroyers, can fit in the inside the shipyard right beside. And Jupiter. They only need 2 measly days to be fully repaired. The Dene has arrived. We'll disband her into the dock, and the harbor defense motor launches are still on patrol. Looks like our ships managed to escape without incident. The Walrus have come off the battleships, so we'll load them with new pilots if we can. Oh, I guess we can't. Now that we've had a day for Alostar to recover a little bit, we'll leave a little while longer. If she can recover the airfield a little bit, we'll send in more fighters. We are overstacked here, but that's fine for the short term. The ship's trying to evacuate from Hong Kong. Look at the direction. You can see the message. They're retreating from an air threat. They're running towards Vietnam to avoid an air threat. We're going to retask them to force them to come down this way. They'll probably be destroyed, but they can't be. They'll be running around forever if we simply let the AI make the decision. So we'll probably have to use either probably a direct route, just to force them to run the sea. Our 3 destroyers here. The Thracian's been heavily damaged at 60% flotation, and fire's still on fire. I think she's going to go down. So there's no point in dragging both destroyers down with them. We're not going to head for Manila. Oh, we could hit for Manila, but there's some task forces moving this way. Well, that's fine. If they engage, they engage. We've discovered a minefield here. So I'm going to, we're going to transfer the 2 little transports over to the other minesweeper, and the single minesweeper is heading back to sweep the mines. We'll change it to a minesweeping mission and set it for patrol right in the mine hex. Yes, I'm crossing a whole bunch of boundaries, but we're simply in the same geographic area. So now I'm going to force these units to run in the direction of Brunei. All right, ordered the ships to ram themselves down towards Brunei, at least they'll move. You just can't trust the AI sometimes. I'm going to try to sweep this minefield because the submarines are still based out of Manila, so they have to traverse the minefield and they could be damaged by it. So here comes the S boat that somehow returned the base, but is now we're sending it back out. The tankers have finished loading, so we're sending them. We'll send them over to Singapore. That's a lot. Another 19,000 in fuel. It's a small amount, but it's better than nothing. The escorts have come out. Looks like they were successful. So we're going to form up a surface group. We'll take the. Oh, we don't need the Canimbla. We may as well switch out and meet and form up with these, merge, take them back in. The transports have arrived at Batavia. I've organized them into one big group. There's a couple of fully loaded AKLs, that's great, but I'm going to make sure I'm trying to get to load a few more. It's just not enough here to make it worthwhile sending an escort. Kuala Lumpur was bombed last time, so we're going to send a squadron of buffaloes to defend. Zero. A squadron of reinforcements arrived. Oh, no pilots, right? So we'll go naval attack. Low altitude attack. And move up to Batavia. The transports at Surabaya have finished loading. It's a real shame to see troop transports that can only transport 1/3 in fuel. But we're going to form a task group and try to push them back into Singapore. A submarine becomes ready and we're sending it back in to attack the beachhead. We're sending the transports through this strait. Hopefully we can pick up the ships over from Batavia. The transports at Surabaya, instead of taking supply out, we're going to try to bring in the troops from Parmakasin. These are isolated islands. We can't evacuate all of them because of their equipment, but at least we can try to steal some of their militia squads. They're going to die anyway, whether they're separated or not, so we'll try to make Surabaya as strong as possible. The transports heading for South Africa are going to split up according to speed, because the fastest have a speed of about 17, while the slowest have a speed of only 12 and 13. So we're going to break up the group. Anything, we'll send the 17s, and we'll form another group, 12s, 13s, 14s, and 15s. The reason for this is, even if with a few knots difference over a long distance, it makes a difference. So if they arrive at different times in Cape Town, they can hopefully have less stress on the American cruisers. Boise has escaped. So we'll send her to Surabaya to run as escort. Another group of the Marblehead and a gang of destroyers will also join up in Surabaya and bring out the next group of transports. Looks like the transports have escaped from Davao. We're not going to go at full. We better go at mission speed, right? Lots of damage because we're running like for our lives, engine damage, but Surabaya should be able to repair that. We're moving up this way instead. We're here already. Most of the transports have been able to leave Manila. We're going to turn them return them to mission speed, because high speed is quite damaging. Clark Airfield has been bombed quite badly, but we're still we're recovering a little. The fortresses have a few of them have recovered. The fighters will get more pilots. We were subjected to night attacks. Wow. What the heck? Okay, we'll fill it up. Better training for us. That's still a good 20 fighters here. Manila, if we have any fighters, okay. We'll have to send, I hate to do it. We'll break up one squadron, divide the squadron. Once it's divided, we'll take the smallest component. We'll fly night combat. And we'll fly... range of, let's say, 1. Just to keep the enemy off our backs. It doesn't have to intercept if they can, to deter the enemy to throw them off their aim. Iba has not been attacked because the fighters here are fairly strong. The enemy attacks have backed off enough, a little further, so we're going to try to order the freighters to run for their lives out from Tacloban. They're going to go out at full speed. The destroyer seaplane tender at Davao, is it? Davao has burned even worse, so she's, along with another merchant ship. Another transport group has escaped and was running for Sor Baja. The cruiser Houston made good her escape to Palawan and is now heading down to Sor Baja. Samarinda has three flights of three small patrols, only about 3 or 4 aircraft each, but we're going to transfer one of them to Tarakan with the expectation that some fighter patrol. The submarine tender has unloaded and will head back to Sor Baja for more. Here's another example of mist. Last time we had ships at Perth, we forgot to move them. So we'll be doing the same. We'll be sending the short range ships to Sydney and Brisbane, and the long range ones to Cape Town for supplies. There are two minesweepers here, and I thought about keeping them in Perth as an escort to, in case any ships get in trouble to bring back. But I just can't see anyone coming directly to Perth. So if we come back from Cape Town, we'll be going directly to one of the other sides. The rail system, Perth is just so far that any supplies or fuel brought into this side would probably be wasted. At Kangaroo Island, we are going to buy out our first unit. This is a base force. I'll turn on the replacements. It's under the Australia Command, and we want it under the 1st Australia Corps. That way, this command is not restricted, and we can load them up and do whatever we like. It'll cost 38 points. We only get 50 a day per turn, so we're wasting 40, and I would normally want to get a nice combat unit out. But we're here, and it's not a total waste for this unit. We're going to form up an amphibious group here. And try to load the base force. Unfortunately, we can turn off load only. We'll verify it, and we're still supposedly 536 troop short. But we'll take it anyway. We'll just have to return for a second mission. But that's all right. We'll return to Adelaide and unload it. I'm doing it. I'm spending the political points now just because I want to get this one out of here and on her way up to Townsville. The ships are here, and I want to pull the ships out of the region, so I'm spending the points now. The transport group heading outbound has now divided into two according to speed. Other outbound transports also meet and merge according to speed. There's the Queen Elizabeth. We'll take her out one more turn and then head back for port. The Townsville group, resupply group, has only loaded about half. But we've already run out, used up, there's only 1,700 left. The AI may not be able to load any more. So we're going to try to increase the supply requirement. Ooh, not maximum, but quite significant. We'll try. When you ask for 4,500, you actually get 15,000. So let's not, we won't be too greedy, but we do need more supplies up here, and we're going to need more later regardless. Here's another example of a screw up by human. Instead, I wanted to evacuate the company from Salamau. However, because of my stupidity, instead of ordering them to pick up troops, I ordered them to transport troops. What an idiot, eh? So now we've got to spend another turn bringing the other troops home. But slowly but surely, we will get them. The French transport group, evacuation group, I guess we could call it, was attacked by a submarine as they left Suva. So we're going to form up the Kingfisher and set it to meet and merge. They'll need all the anti-submarine protection. Over at Guam, this is the minesweeper that had run for her life and managed to escape. But she's heading deeper into enemy territory. So, we're going to try and sneak our way down to Alitepe. Make our way across and hope we don't get detected by the aircraft from Truk. It's a little ship in a big ocean, but the enemy has enough patrols. It got patrols to the west, to the east, and to the southeast. Over at Pearl, we have a detection report. It says these are heavy cruisers and fast transports or destroyers. And looking at this and wondering, really? Is this the carrier group? It could have moved from here to here, but we can't confirm sighting of a carrier. So I've lost track of the damn things. I think we're going to... Okay, we have our aircraft. I think it might be due to my fear of submarines. I have been flying my aircraft perhaps a little bit too low. So instead... they're at 5,000. So it's not like they're low altitude. I thought they were flying at 2,000. But no, they're at 5,000. They should be able to spot the carriers. So I've lost track of the enemy carrier group. That's not a good thing. At least we know he's not still sitting here where my submarines are. I'm going to assume he's headed back. There was a detection report under the operational report. There's some detection report, torpedo bomber detection, I think it was. Don't know the exact one. Oh gosh, where was it now? Maybe not here. I thought there was a torpedo bomber detected. Here. Japanese aircraft. Well, so I'm hoping they're retiring and we can finally get underway with our operations. But I'm going to send the submarines over out on their regular war patrol now. The carriers are going to head back towards Pearl to recover their aircraft. We'll make sure we'll do it the safe way. We'll head... I'll use a waypoint. I don't know why the AI constantly wants me to run towards the enemy. Look at that. Oh, just okay. Really? Really? Okay. Well, we'll change the waypoint. There's no drag and drop in this game. The cruisers were all, and the minesweeper group will also head back. Jeez, why do they, when you set it, they always get as close as they can to the enemy and then run across. That's at least the way I think it works. Just stay away. Oh, it looks like there is some kind of threat here that the AI is trying to avoid. Well, we'll have to set it. Gosh, just have to override the AI. Pearl Harbor has still not yet recovered. Wow, that's a lot of damage. Even with this many engineers and engineering vehicles, we haven't been able to clear it quickly enough. So maybe another day or two before we actually have everything back in order. Problem is, I cannot order my engineers. They're the ones helping clear the damage. So I can't order them into strategic mode, getting ready to pack. But I will order the Marines into strategic mode, the defensive battalions, because the enemy obviously is not going to conduct a landing. Just to give you an idea of, here's a restricted infantry regiment for the Hawaiian department. In order for us to buy it out, we need 530 points. That's four times what we have right now. So it's a long wait to buy out anything. Nothing else here has any combat value. We can send aviation battalion and some base forces. Of course, we will send them, but to stand up to enemy landing forces, we'll need infantry. The armed merchant cruisers have caught up to the transports and will now transfer in. This is kind of the ideal situation. This is their role, to go into slightly dangerous places where you wouldn't want to send a normal Navy ship. There's a minesweeper returning, but I've also got five up here. I just took a look and I realized just how few escorts I have on the west coast. So I'm going to leave two in the north and send the rest down to San Francisco. We don't even have anything to escort little ships, because the Japanese submarines will be showing up sooner or later. There come two more KVs and three more. We're going to use the first two. Okay, I'm going to try to do something a little bit funky here. The transports have arrived. That's great. They've replenished. Now they're waiting to load. We'll disband them into the dock. In the dock, we have a number of ships already. These little ships here, I'm going by speed. Here's an oiler to Patoka. To Patoka, we may as well make it, create it. Oops. Create a... form a new task force. We're going to take the Patoka. She's loading supplies. We'll give it a destination of Pearl Harbor, because Pearl is using up fuel and supplies quite quickly. We're going to try to resupply right away. She'll load up. She needs another 800 or so points of fuel. We don't want to. We'll remain on station. But she's alone, so she's going to finish loading these other ships here. The oilers, they are fairly large, and we're going to send them on deep strike all the way down to Australia. So we're going to transfer these ships. They're already fully loaded. Into the base. A word of caution, when another ship arrives at the base and refuels, The problem, I find it problematic, the AI tends to grab the fuel out of the oilers first, even though they've already been disbanded into the base. Rather than grabbing this 1 million points worth of fuel right at the base, they grab it out of the ones loaded on the oiler. Which means that the replenishment vessel, we have to keep resupplying, reloading the tenders every time. But no ships are coming in right now, otherwise I would just keep them separate. Okay, so we've got tankers here. They haven't finished loading yet. They're about halfway through. But these little freighters are already full. So we're going to form another transport group. I'm going to add the three little full freighters. We'll turn them off. We're going to set them to follow the oiler. So it's going to follow Task Force 277. So this one, it'll finish halfway through the turn and immediately set sail. We're going to order the corvettes to meet 277 and merge with it. So we'll just have a couple of escorts to take them down through the submarine infested waters. I haven't seen any submarines around here yet. That's why I can take this risk and send them off. Otherwise, I would have to escort them from port to port. Here's another task group that's been loading. It's the tankers take a long time to load. So we're going to form another transport group. We're going to take the loaded AKL. God, what a mess, trying to... And the loaded oiler. The oiler will stop from unloading. We're going to set it to meet 277 and also join up. The other task groups, some of them are already loaded. Some of them are not, so we're going to transfer the complete ones back into the base to make room at the dock for unloaded ones. We also have some here, some half loads, I'll call them. Don't want to see the port ones. God, how can they keep messing this? We won't unload. We'll also set them to meet 277 to merge. See how there's almost no escorts around here for this kind of thing. The base force here is already in position, or it's already packed. So we're going to form another transport group. Liberty. We'll have room to dock now. Let's try to load it. We're loading them early. Or we could take a couple of air groups with us. Oh, that's an interesting proposition. No, we'll take a fighter group, but later. We'll check the selected unit and see that, it says that there's still, use the minimum. Wow. Let's remove a small one. There we go. It still says unverified. So what I'm going to do is, well, there's a small ship. We'll take a... We'll transfer out. We have time. So we're going to move out one of the small ones. If necessary, we can always use it to grab one of the bomber squadrons and load it for transshipment. So I think we'll try to load it this way. And if worse comes to worse, we'll just load fuel. See, it still says the same 362. Oops. Turn off, load only. We'll verify. And sometimes it loads up, but we don't know. Sometimes it is sufficient. We're going to do the same up here. We have room. We have certain units are already in strategic mode. So there we can load them already. We're going to form up some ships. Oh, which ones? Oops, no, transport. We'll take the biggest ones first. We're docked. Turn off the unload. Let's see if we can load troops. It's set for Noumea. That helps. The base force. Uh-oh, now we are... And this... Oops. Some of these aren't ready to load yet. We better make sure we have the right one. We'll just click on it. These are unloaded, even though it shows that it says that they're ready to load. They are not. This is the one that disappears after 6 months. So it's the 47th construction, 112, 47th, 112, and the 198th field artillery. The 198th, the 111th, the 47th, hold on, it's not the 111th, it's the 112th, I think those are the ones. Someone correct me if I'm wrong. We want to load everything, so we'll verify. It says use minimum, so obviously we could use more troop capacity, so we're going to add a ship, and it takes the personnel personnel transport. We don't want to use up all the space, so let's take off a couple of them. But we'll use the other three to hopefully load up all these. Even if we all we do is load extras. So that pretty much one extra ship per unit. We'll accept the load. By doing it in two stages, we are taking there's less stress on the port facilities. Also, you will see if at the end of the loading period, quite often you'll see this motorized transport sitting on the dock as you sail away. So by having a few extra ships around, we can load up any forgotten motorized transport. We'll do the same for the Marines. The Marines have a couple. Oh wow, there's a couple left over. The base force, the 1/10th, and the port service, but the others are ready to go. We have the 1st Amphibious Corps, a headquarters, that's helpful. So we're going to look for which big units are ready. We can take the Pacific Fleet ones. So not the 1/10th and not the detachment, but everything else we can try to load. So let's form. We'll take the biggest transports. So the amphibious transport too. Let's do a practice load. We're docked. We're not taking this one yet. The 1/10 can't go yet. So it's the 101st. Gosh, better make sure. Double check that again. 101st Defensive Battalion. The 8th Marine Regiment, the Corps. Wow. Okay, here's a way to do it. We'll put it in reserve. So, I think that'll mean when we try to load, it won't allow you to load. Yes, that's right. It doesn't show up in load. That's good. So we'll check load, 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 load. We want to load everything. Let's verify the load. It says 3% over and 100. Nope, that's not enough. So let's add a ship. It's 40% over. I think we can accept this one. I'm fairly certain there's going to be amphibious or motorized elements left over, but that's why we have extra ships we can load next turn. We'll go back here. And we'll set these back to strategic. So it'll still pack in one day. I'm bringing these naval support squads along because in these large ports, the naval support helps, but it doesn't help. There's already a large port, so we already have large loading facilities. When you're on a tiny, tiny little island like, that's either Suva, which is not too small, Suva or Noumea, which only has two, trying to unload a few thousand tons, every little bit helps. The tanker at Portland is going to head for San Francisco at its earliest convenience. A couple of squadrons of Bolos were here last turn, and we'll move them over to Ogden. Like all good little bolos. Do a quick check in Ogden. Yep, still plenty of room. Plenty of room for bombers. There's only 51 required, so lots of mechanics for the bombers available. Submarine attack. Uh-oh, the seaplane tender Poolster has been hit. Leog, near the Philippines. Sea Dragon attacks. Launches two torpedoes, but either missed or duds. Interesting. Merchants versus merchants. Another submarine attack. Same place, or not same place, but near. Another dud, perhaps. The Dutch skippers also launch an attack. The Dutch skippers fire at one and hit a transport, an AK. Well, this is an amphibious assault transport near the Patani invasion site. Surprised that the AI would waste a night attack on a little infantry at Victoria Point, Burma, but okay. Night air attack on Mulmian. This is where I'm planning a defense line in Burma, but we don't have any fighters left to spare for a night defense. Another Dutch sub attack at Singora. Amphibious landing at Apari. This is just northeast of Manila. The Dutch skippers are aggressive. We take 17 hits. Uh-oh. We launch an attack, but fail to hit anything. Another sub-attack near the same base. Expending lots of torpedoes. Another air attack on Wake Island. They're pumping fumes, but we supposedly destroyed four. Damn. Air attack on Kuantan. We have no interceptors, and a number of bombers are destroyed on the ground. Some heavy hits. Maybe I forgot to put some fighters over this base. Air attack on Batangas near Manila. We get one enemy unescorted bomber. Another air attack, and the little P-26 fight hard. A damaged bomber could be a loss, and another valuable crew killed, because he's got to fly such a long distance to get here. Kuantan hit again. And again. Several hits. The RAF try to get back and strike at Kota Bharu. No Japanese losses, but we lose a swordfish. Hong Kong bombed from Vietnam. One runway hit. Oh, we actually destroyed possibly one torpedo bomber. The Blenheims attack the enemy amphibious force. No loss. Oh, we lose one Blenheim. The Burmese battalion, as it tries to retreat, is bombed for heavy loss of life. Another sub-attack near Laog. Looks like more duds. I can't tell when it is a dud or when it's just a plain miss. The enemy launches amphibious assault at Vigan. That's the north, right beside Apari. Simultaneous invasion of Wake Island. Kota Bharu attacks at 4-1 level. The base is captured. We take heavy losses as we retreat into the jungle. Two units are destroyed. Wake Island attacked. Uh-oh. Captured. 5-1. No flights. Looks like I'm going to lose that. All the wildcats are destroyed, and I lose the pilots as well.
Government announced that victorious forces of the Japanese Empire have captured Wake.
Actually, the Indian Brigade retreats from Kota Bharu towards Tumalo. We wouldn't see this. I stated it earlier. We would not see this in the text report. I don't think the surrenders are recorded either, but I'm not positive. The enemy storms ashore at Tarawa, capturing it right away.